This is Pierre. He's 6 years old. Pierre is still sucking his thumb. He has a slight speech impediment, a lisp. His mom, Isabel, has also noticed that his teeth are not straight and that he breathes through his mouth and not through his nose. What's the cause of Pierre's problems? And how can we treat them? Let's see why. This is Emma. She's 1 year old. She sucks her thumb and swallows while suckling. Like all the kids of her age, she also has a pacifier. She's in primary swallowing. Emma's tongue fills all the space in her mouth and acts as a suction pump to enable Emma to swallow. This way of eating and swallowing is physiological until the child is 3 years old. But this method should change when the molars erupt and mastication starts. This is Mary, Emma's big sister. She's 6. She has a diversified diet which requires mastication. She stopped sucking her thumb and using a pacifier before she turned 4. She naturally switched to secondary swallowing. Her tongue is in an upper position, behind the teeth and against the palate. 2,000 times a day during swallowing, her tongue adjusts the shape of her palate and leaves enough space for her growing teeth. Thanks to a cross-chain effect, she has a clear diction and good nasal breathing. Let's go back to Pierre. He still has his baby's habits, and he hasn't yet reached the secondary stage of swallowing. However, unlike Emma, he has teeth. Every time he swallows, his tongue steps in between his teeth and causes deformations. Here again, due to a cross-chain effect, Pierre breathes through his mouth and has trouble pronouncing some words. Unfortunately, the nose, which serves as a good air filter, is not used, so Pierre is more likely to fall ill. Pierre's mother, Isabelle, brings him to a health professional. She prescribes a Froggymouth for Pierre. This little device of rehabilitation of mouth and face function is inspired by the work on memory of a Nobel Prize in Medicine. It restores both correct swallowing and nasal breathing with only 15 minutes used per day in front of the TV. Thanks to the disconnection between the lips, it makes primary swallowing impossible, and Pierre will subconsciously have to find a new and better way to position his tongue. After a few weeks of rehabilitation with Froggymouth, Pierre is in good health and is ready to face the challenges of growing up. Did you know that 40% of children and 30% of adults suffer from atypical swallowing? If you want to check if you have a good swallowing function, make an appointment with your practitioner.